Communion this morning will be by intention. The ushers will, a row at a time, disperse you to one side of this small table in the center or the other, where you receive the bread to dip into a chalice of wine or of juice. And then you may return to your seat. If you are unable to come forward for intention, let one of the ushers know, and at the end of service, we will come to you. It's fitting that we share communion today, because the communion hymn, which we have been using now for the past several weeks, which we will sing again today, as reads a week, speaks to our sense of community in Christ. So I urge you once more, when we sing those words, to pay attention to the meaning of the lyrics. As the grains of wheat are scattered on the hill, are gathered into one to become our bread, gathered into one, so may all your people, from all the ends of earth, be gathered into one of you. This bread symbolizes what Paul is trying to tell us, that we exist to be together. We create together something more holy and substantial and benefit to all than we can ever do apart. So may we begin. The loving God is with us.
And with all creation.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the living God.
Let us give thanks to the Creator of all.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right, good, and joyful, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, living God, who loves us with the faithful care of the Father and Mother. And so we join with all creation to proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy one, God of power, God of love, earth, sea, and sky, are full of your glory. With joy we praise you. With joy we praise you. Amen.
We praise and bless you, holy and gracious Creator, source of all life. Your Spirit has always been with creation, guiding its development, calling forth life, infusing beauty, inspiring joy and love. In your infinite love, you created us in your image and allowed us to share the precious gift of life. You gave us a home in which to live in harmony with you, one another, and all your creatures. But we have so often turned from your love and wisdom, choosing our own way, breaking faith with you, our neighbors, and our fellow creatures. All around us, we see the tragic harvest of the bitter weed we have sown. Yet through it all, you have remained faithful to us. You generously called us to turn from our destructive ways and to return to you. You sent us prophets, priests, sages, storytellers, and poets to lead us to repentance and wisdom. In the fullness of time, through Mary, a humble woman of faith, you sent Jesus into the world. Living among us, Jesus loved us. Word and deed, he proclaimed the good news of your name. He broke bread with outcasts and sinners, and in imitation of your perfect love, he taught us to love neighbor, stranger, outsider, and enemy. He redirected us from violence to peace, from fear to faith, from rivalry to mutual service, and from worry and greed to generosity and joy. And so we sing in praise.
People.
bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Then his supper was ending, he took the cup of wine and again gave thanks, offering the cup to his friends, saying, "Drink from this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this cup, remember me." Now gathered as one family around this table of joyful reconciliation and fellowship, united in your spirit, we receive these gifts and we gratefully offer you our lives as a living sacrifice. As Christ stretched out his arms upon the cross to welcome the whole world into your gracious embrace, we rejoice to enter that embrace and with you extend it to all, saying together, through Christ
and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, to the living God be honor, glory, and grace, forever and ever. Amen.
This bread which we break is the communion of the body of Christ. This cup of blessing which we bless, the communion also, body of Christ. Come, for all things are now ready. I invite the ushers to come forward.
Thank you.
Please rise for prayer and thanksgiving. Sharing God, as Christ's body and blood were separated on the cross, so now they have been rejoined in us. Let us then, by faith, now arise, filled with the Spirit, as we have been fed around God's table of grace,